Mercedes. Okay? You sell a Mercedes. What's the average price on a Mercedes, roughly?
$35,000 to $40,000.
All right, cool. Let's say the price is going to be $39,900. And what kind of car are we going to be selling on Mercedes? What?
C300.
Cool. C300. Price is $39,900. I have a trade in here. Okay, and you're giving me $9,000 for it. Okay. It doesn't even matter what it is. It doesn't matter. Okay, that's going to be a $30,009 difference, right? Plus the customer's payoff. Is that usually how your managers pencil a deal, kind of like that?
Yes.
Okay, and they're going to say 6.99% on 72 months. The payment's going to be $589 a month. Okay?
Yeah.
Does that make sense? Does that kind of look like how a deal would look?
Yeah, it's very similar. They always have APR.
Cool. So every store is different, but this is your store. Present it to me. Now I'm your customer. Let's rock and roll.
Hey, Andy, so we got got the vehicle right here. Terms of the loan. Price of the vehicle.
Okay.
Trade-in value. Monthly payment.
Okay.
And you like the vehicle title in where? In your name or you and your wife's name?
I'd like it titled in both our names, but that price is too high.
I guess I'm not wrapping my head around.
Okay.
Why I need just call?
What part?
I don't want to.
What about the price? Do you think is too high? Is it the? Okay. Yeah. No.
That's okay. No, I want you to be you.
Okay, be me.
Yeah,
like how I would say it, right?
Yeah. Okay. You're not me. I want you to be you right now. Show me what you normally do. I think the price is too high.
So, why do you think the price is too high?
Well, I saw one down the road for $37,000.
Okay.
So I did a little looking before I came in, and that's $3,000 higher.
Okay. Perfect. So, over here at Mercedes-Benz of San Jose, we have 120-point inspection on all of our vehicles. And this car is actually, it only has 2,000 miles on it. It's a certified pre-owned. You have bumper-to-bumper warranty. So the other vehicle that we're talking about, it's probably going to have more miles.
But it had 4,000 miles.
Okay. So it has like 2,000 more miles.
Yeah, it's $3,000 less.
$3,000 less. Okay. So, what would it take during your business?
I know. See, that's where you want to go. Okay.
Yeah.
That's like saying, hey, you want to punch me in the mouth?
Yeah.
No.
That's what I always say.
Yeah, don't say that.
Don't say that.
No ways. All right? Because guess what? There's a difference between being a closer and being a master closer. A closer can close a deal and negotiate down. A master closer doesn't negotiate down, but he closes for all the money. Will I pay $39,900? Sure. As long as you give me the reasons and the excuses why I should pay for it. Would you agree?
I agree.
But you're not giving them.
I'm not.
And that right there is the secret sauce on why salesmen fail at defending these pencils that they get in dealerships constantly. And most managers can't do it either.
Mm-hmm.
And they do the same thing that you do.
Yeah.
Okay?
So if I gave you for the same price as the car down the road.
Yeah, so if I match their price,
yeah,
you
do
a little more.
Do it today? Yeah,
you know,
sign right here.
Yeah, so how about I show you how to handle this objection?
Amazing.
Okay.
Cool.
Number one.
Can I be a difficult, I'll be a difficult customer?
Well, just be me with who I was.
Okay.
We'll just switch it around.
Cool.
We're gonna play the same scenario because I don't wanna get off the scenario.
Cool.
The scenario is I saw one that $3,000 cheaper down the road,
mm-hmm.
right? So let me show you how to overcome that one and then we'll move to different scenarios.
Perfect.
Okay, so check this out. My deal is that I want you to understand that what I'm about to do in a seated position, everything is written. Did you write one thing on this piece of paper?
No.
Why?
Because it's already written for me.
No. See this ink pen? This is your sword. Okay? You see this piece of paper right here? This is before I got involved. You want to see what a closer looks like whenever I'm done here in a minute? See this? Watch this. All right, so I got great news, sir. So at $39,900 with $9,000 for your trade, I got your APR and your term. Your payment's going to be $589 a month. We're going to pay your vehicle off. And I apologize, I forgot to ask you, when did you want to set your first payment due? Towards the beginning of the month, the middle of the month? What's going to work best for you and your family?
So actually, the beginning of the month works.
Okay, awesome. So like around the 1st or the 5th, when?
The 5th's fine.
Okay, cool. I'm just going to write the 5th right here. And if you'll sign right there, I'll get your new car cleaned up.
Just a quick question.
Sure, go ahead, anything.
Can you see
how I'm moving?
Yeah, you've left nothing open. Yeah.
That's right. So I want you to watch my presentation versus your presentation.
Okay.
Now let's go ahead. Now you stop me. You got an objection. I'm okay with that. Go ahead. What's your objection?
So there's a car down the road, the exact same car down the road. I think it has maybe 2,000 more miles on it. It's around $3,000 less.
And when you say $3,000 less,
so the car costs essentially it's the same vehicle for $3,000 less. So why would I pay more for this vehicle, for the same vehicle?
Okay, so did you drive the vehicle?
I did not.
Okay, so you saw an advertisement, right?
Yes.
For a vehicle that looks comparable to mine, mm-hmm. for $3,000 less.
Correct.
Is that right? Okay, awesome. Are you familiar with the difference between the purchase price and the ownership price of the vehicle?
No.
Okay, let me show you something. This is us. This is Mercedes of San Jose. You know what I'm saying? We'll just put San Jose right here. And this over here, what's the name of the dealership? ABC Motors, where you're looking at it? What's the name of the place you're going to look at it?
Infinity Bay Shop.
Cool, awesome, I love it. So they're not a Mercedes store, are they?
They're not.
Okay, I'm gonna tell you something, all right? Number one, before I even get into anything, I wanna explain something to you. A Mercedes technician is made for one thing, for Mercedes. Okay, going to a Nissan house, Toyota house, Lexus house, Infiniti. They're not the same technicians. They don't have the same tools. You know, if you go to Infiniti right now, I'm gonna share something with you. They don't carry Mercedes-Benz tools. Would you agree?
I agree.
Okay, with that being said, we carry certified pre-owned. You just started with that, am I right?
Yeah.
And guess what? Do you know what certified pre-owned is? Obviously you don't. Because if you did, you wouldn't be looking at the Infiniti store.
Correct.
Okay, so I wanna explain something to you. When I talked about the purchase price is a one-time spend. It's actually the money that you're gonna be spending today. Our price is $39,900. Over here at ABC Motors or at Infiniti, whatever, you said their price was $37,000. That's a $2,900 difference. This right here, I'm gonna write the word purchase price and I want you to think about something. Purchase price, again, is the price you spend today. Look. Let's say we were gonna buy a car for your little sister, okay? And we found a car for $3,000. And we were like, well, that's her first car, you know what I'm saying? And we saw another one for $4,500. A little bit nicer, you know what I'm saying? But you know, $3,000 sounds like a good deal. So we're like, hey, let's spend a little less money. We spend that $3,000, we buy the car for her. Car's perfect. She drives the car for 6 months, transmission goes out. Say it costs $3,000 to fix it. How much was the purchase price on the car we purchased for your sister? $3,000. How much did it cost to own total after the time we were done with it?
The same.
$6,000. Yeah, because that was the total money spent. Now you work hard for your money. Mm-hmm. You put your money in the bank. When the money's spent out of the bank, that's real money spent, right? Right. How much did the car cost, $3,000 or $6,000?
$6,000.
What was the purchase price?
$37,000.
$3,000. The purchase price was $3,000.
Okay.
And we spent $3,000 on it. So the ownership price was $6,000, but the purchase price was $3,000. So the question is, can the purchase price be lower, but the cost to own it actually be much more?
Yes.
Yes. And that's what I want to explain to you. The difference between the purchase price and the ownership price are two completely different prices. But if money is your real concern, which I think when you tell me the price is too high, that basically what you're saying is money is a concern to me, let's watch out for the money. I'm gonna show you where the real money's at now. Over here at $39,900 on my vehicle,
yes.
I do a 127 point inspection, okay? We got these, we call them pre-owned certified. What's a pre-owned certified warranty cover? It covers A and it goes to Z, okay? You have your manufacturer's warranty here. Do you know that my car has 2,000 miles on it and their car has 4,000 miles? We say, well, Andy, those are only 2,000 miles difference. There's not much difference. Let me ask you a question. When does the bumper-bumper warranty run out on a Mercedes? 4-year 50?
50,000. Unless it's certified pre-owned, then 75.
4-year 50. So since this car over here is not certified pre-owned, it's gonna run out at 4-year 50,000. Am I right? So ask me this question. At 50,000 miles, when's the warranty gonna be? I mean, you got 4,000 miles on this car now. When's the warranty gonna be out? At 50,000 miles, over here at Infiniti. When you purchase my car today, how many miles do you get that same warranty for?
75.
Can I ask you a question? Do you know how much it costs per hour labor in a Mercedes service station? Per hour to work on a car. Do you know how much per hour it costs?
I think it's depends. I think it's like, what is it, 112? I think 113.
Okay.
It's something like that.
Okay. Let's say it's $113. Okay.
Yeah.
Do you know how much Mercedes parts cost? They're the best cars in the world.
Yeah.
But they're also expensive to maintain. You see, if a car is high in all the critical areas that are important to you and your family, and it's a great vehicle, well, it's going to get replaced with quality parts. And you're not going to replace it with aftermarket parts. You're going to put Mercedes parts back on it. Am I right?
Right.
So would you agree that those Mercedes parts are going to be expensive?
Yes.
I want to ask you a question. When this car runs out at 50,000 miles, every mile over 50,000 at 50,001, who pays for all the stuff that has to be done bumper to bumper on the car? At 55,000 miles, if your navigation went out on your Mercedes, how much do you think it would cost you?
A lot.
Just guess.
$3,000, $4,000.
It's going to cost more than that.
Oh, more than that?
Yeah.
Maybe 5 or 6.
A navigation replacement part on a factory Mercedes car, $5,500. Now I want to ask this question. Whether it costs $5,500, $10,000, or $1. Bottom line is, if it happened at 50,001, who would have to pay for it?
You.
You. So you would have to pay that money out of pocket, am I right? Just like we talked about that car we'd be buying for your sister. Anything that breaks after the purchase price, we would have to pay for. But that's the real money spent. So, if you didn't buy my car today and you went over here to Infinity Motors and you bought this vehicle, you feel like you got a better deal today, you're driving down the road, you put 20,000 miles a year on your car, whatever, 2 years from now you look up, you're out of warranty. Cars are machines. They have over 1,000 working pieces on a machine. Do you think they're going to break? Of course. They're machines. When they do break, at 50,000 and every penny over, you're going to have to pay for that. Over here with us. Here, let me let Gian in. Over here with us.
I'm looking at this.
How are you?
Good.
So watch this. Gian, you want to get on a little training here in a minute?
Yeah, sure.
Hey, so 50,000 miles, every penny over that, guess what? Who has to pay for that? You do. Over here on my car, guess what? Our warranty runs to 75,000 miles. Let me ask you, how many miles do you drive a year?
12.
Okay. That gives you an extra 2 years of driving to know that you have maintenance-free driving. I'm going to ask you a question. When you buy this vehicle today and you drive out of here, this is a beautiful car you're buying. You would probably keep it as long as you possibly can. You know how expensive cars are now. We're probably going to be even more expensive in 2 years from now. Would you agree?
I agree.
Do you want to be back in here buying another car in 2 years?
No.
Okay. So with this vehicle right here, if you don't buy my car today and you went and bought ABC Motors car over here at Infinity Motors, you'd be able to drive it for 3 years under warranty. Am I right?
Right.
But if 3 years runs out of warranty, you're going to either have to spend $5,000 or $6,000 on an extended warranty, right?
Right.
Or come back in and get in the trade cycle again and buy another vehicle. For how much? $40,000, $50,000? On our vehicle, guess what? You can drive those same 3 years, but add another 25,000 miles. Guess what?
Okay.
Now it allows you to drive 5 years. Let me ask you this. If you knew that you could make a good educated decision and buy my car today and know that for the next 5 years, when you were driving this vehicle, it's all under warranty and you don't have to worry about anything, the trade cycle alone is longer and you get to own your vehicle longer, which means you don't have to trade it as soon as spend more. But also anything that breaks, which we know something will break, right or wrong.
Right.
Me and you can agree on one thing. Something's gonna break on this car. And when it does, if there's a warranty in place like this because it's certified pre-owned, who's gonna pay for it? I am. But not if you buy across the street. So here's what I'll tell you. When you say to me that the price is too high, what you mean to say is, Andy, I think the price on the vehicle across the road is less money. Can you please justify why your price is a little bit higher than theirs? With the presentation that I've just made, I want to show you something. I'm going to save you $10,000 in repairs, I promise you, on stuff that you're going to have to spend, plus peace of mind and convenience. How well are you going to sleep tonight knowing that when you purchased my car, you made a good educated decision, knowing that the next 5 years that you own this vehicle in your trade cycle, if anything breaks, it's going to be paid for, and you don't have anything to worry about. Where over here, you could have had the anxiety of knowing that whenever something does break, it could cost a lot of money. Knowing that it's Mercedes and it's expensive, it will be expensive, and all that money is gonna come right here from your pocketbook. So, when you say the price is too high, what you mean is you're willing to pay a little more in the purchase price, as long as in the end the ownership price is much less. Because guess what? This purchase price is actually considerably low since you're getting a certified pre-owned car. Does that make sense?
That makes sense.
You're getting a warranty. And by the way, I want to ask you a question. Are you having to go purchase an extended warranty on this vehicle right now to get that?
No.
No. So over here, when they go and sell you this car for $37,000, the guy goes in the service department, he says, hey, guess what? Or in the finance department, he says, hey, in 2 years, you're going to be out of warranty on this car. Do you want to buy an extended warranty? And you're going to sign a piece of paper that says, no, I waive any coverage on this vehicle. I don't want to be protected. No, you're not going to sign that piece of paper. You know what you're going to do? You're going to say, sure, I would like to have a warranty on it after 2 years. And he's going to say, great, I got a good one right here for you, $5,000. And by the time you add that $37,000 back to that $5,000, where are you at now? You're at $43,000 because you had to purchase an extended warranty to get the same type of coverage here that you had on this Mercedes. And at the end of the day, over here at Infinity, do you think that's going to be a Mercedes warranty or an aftermarket warranty?
Aftermarket.
Do you want an aftermarket warranty or a Mercedes warranty made for Mercedes?
Mercedes warranty.
Sir, I think we fully have talked about this. You understand the justification of why our vehicles may be a little more in the beginning, but they save you so much more over the end. And if money's your real concern, that's all that matters. Am I right? 90% of our customers have agreed that the ownership price is much more important than the purchase price because that's a true money spend. I've just made my entire presentation over that. You know that you're making the best decision. If you'll just sign right here on this payment, I'll get your new car cleaned up. Thank you so much.
Nice.
Look. Hold on. What do you see? Written.
Everything's written.
Everything is written. Did I close you?
Yeah.
Hell yeah, I closed you.
Yeah, definitely.
Listen.
You probably would have closed me just based off just not stopping. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
So like what you were saying in the beginning,
you
don't give anyone the chance to say anything.
No, but am I confident?
Yes.
Do I seem like I'm an expert in my field?
Yes.
Do I seem like I'm trying to find answers or think about what's my next move?
No.
No. It's just like you with fighting with your legs. That's what I want you to understand. You memorize these word tracks. And by the way, okay, I want you to understand this. Do I sound like a car salesman?
No.
Kick the car salesman out of you. Okay? Be an investor and be an advisor. And if you'll do that, you will be deadly. Presentation is everything. I don't give a shit how much you know. If you can't present it well, you're screwed. Okay? You see my eye contact that I've had with you the whole time?
Yeah, it's very strong.
Yeah, I don't break it. You know what that shows? That shows I'm a good businessman. If I'd had a wife right here, I'd have been looking at her too the entire time, letting you guys know that I'm the person you can trust and to do business with. And listen, at the end of the day, I'm not going to make up your mind for you. I think you guys are smart people. Since I keep talking about these smart decisions that all these other smart people are making, what do people want to do? What other people are doing? Am I right?
Right.
So you notice I use a social proof close nonstop. Okay?
Social proof
close. Uh-huh. And social proof close means this, that what everyone else is doing, everyone else wants to do. Does that make sense?
Yes.
Okay? Now watch this. In a seated position, everything is written.
A seated position,
everything is written. Standing, it's all verbal. Okay? But in a seated position, everything is written. Okay? Closers write. Do you know why we write when we're sitting down? Because 90% of what is written is retained. Okay? I want you to think about this for a minute. While I'm talking and you look down, you can keep remembering all the things that I've gone over. Am I right?
Right.
Because it's right here. Remember, during a negotiation, people will remember the last three things that said, or the last sentence or the last paragraph of what said. Just by default, they'll forget everything else you've talked about. So guess what? If I don't write anything down, you know what will happen? I will have made an entire presentation that they will only remember the last of what I said. And so if you don't write it down, what happens is you end up at the end of your presentation doing this. Doesn't that make sense? And then they're like, well, yeah, I kind of like what you said, but you know what? I kind of forgot it already because my mind is trying to retain what it is you're telling me right now. So I forgot what we talked about a minute ago. Can you forget now? Listen. See this? Remember the 127-point inspection? Remember the warranty? Remember the longer? Remember that? See this magic sword? I'm writing it down. So since I'm writing it down, it's all right here. And guess what? People are visual. Why is YouTube so big? Because people love watching video. Okay? They love watching video. You can't just talk. Okay? Some people will retain stuff with talking, but guess what? This right here, this is your magic weapon, okay? So in a seated position, everything is written. Cool? Okay. So go ahead. Any questions?
Yes. So, so a common problem that I have for AutoNation, there's two. But another one is this. There's other Mercedes stores that have certified pre-owned.
Okay, let's go to the next one.
For cheaper.
Watch,
for
hold, cheaper hold, and less hold, hold on. Abracadabra, bro, I got to close for everything. It doesn't matter. I'm just using what you said.
Yeah,
okay? Nice. All right, so 35, we're just going to do 39.9.
Yeah.
We're going to forget about everything else. Okay? Say the price too high.
The price is too high.
Sign here, the price too high. Okay, when you say the price is too high, would you mind being more specific why you think the price is too high?
Yeah, Mercedes-Benz of Pleasanton has a certified pre-owned, same year, C300, actually less miles. For a cheaper price, for around $3,000 less, and I just don't want to pay more money.
No,
no. I like you.
Yeah. No, I appreciate it.
I just don't want to pay more money for the same car.
And I appreciate that, and I love it. I appreciate you telling me all this information. Number one, have you driven that vehicle? Tell me you've driven it. Go ahead.
I have.
That's fine.
Yeah.
I think that's important.
I have. I've test driven it.
Awesome. So let's write this down together and let's talk about it. Okay. All right. So here's my vehicle. It's $39,900, and I'm gonna put us. And this is going to be ABC Mercedes, okay, that has the same vehicle for $37,000. Is that right?
That's right.
Okay, I'm going to ask you one question, just one. What does that say?
Why?
The first question I ask is this, why aren't you sitting in that car owning it right now? Do you know why? More than likely, 99% of statistics say that why someone didn't purchase that vehicle because the deal stinks or something was wrong with it. Look, I'm gonna tell you this. It doesn't matter how cheap something is. You work hard for your money, right?
Right.
You sound like, I mean, obviously I don't know how much exactly that you make, but you seem like you make really good money, okay? With that being said, how much are you worth an hour? If I just had to give in a guess, are you worth $500 an hour?
Yeah.
Okay.
$400 or $500.
Okay, how much time did you spend at that dealership? Probably 2 hours?
2.5.
Cool, so you spent almost $1,500 in your time at that dealership, but yet you didn't drive it off the lot. You know what I've learned? Smart people like you make decisions logically here over money, but guess what? Money's not the ultimate concern of everything. You make decisions here with your stomach, whether it's the right car you want to put in your driveway, because you don't put price in your driveway, you put value in your driveway. And value is what you anticipate, what you would love to own. Price has nothing to do with it. I could be selling my car right now for $50,000 or for a dollar. It doesn't matter. If you don't see yourself driving it every day and you can't envision it in your driveway, you won't spend your money. People spend their money when they want what they see in front of them more than they want the money that they have in their pocket. Okay? That price didn't matter at $37,000. It wasn't the right color. It smelled like smoke. It was a scratch you couldn't get over. Something. And that's why I have you sitting here with me right now. So what I want to tell you is a guy like you that makes a ton of money, you already wasted $1,500 in your money that you work hard for, just sitting there looking at vehicles that you're not interested in. Now, I know this. You wouldn't be sitting here with me at the table right now if you wouldn't have already made that decision that you want to see this car sitting in your driveway. I'm positive of that. So what person? Number one, I know this. You're going to be happy with my car. That's the first thing that I know.
Yeah.
And ultimately, I don't care about money. I care about that. Because customer satisfaction is everything. And I'm going to tell you this, all right? Again, going back to the fact that you make good money isn't everything. You can always get more money, but you can never get more time. How much more time are you going to put into going around and trying to find the perfect car and then worrying about the money? Can I ask you a question? Is that price too high? No. But because you looked at another car that you really didn't want to own and you saw that had a cheaper price, it had a cheaper price for a reason, okay? And what I say is this, in your gut, there's 10 other people that looked at that same car and they didn't purchase it either, and they're looking for this same car. And what I'll tell you is, when you talk about a Mercedes, $2,900 is nothing. You know why? Because you buy a car like this, not just for status, but for love. for the way that you love the way the vehicle drives. You love seeing the symbol of the Mercedes, right? The power of the Mercedes, the luxury of the Mercedes. People don't settle for Mercedes. You know what you settle for? The Toyota Corolla. Okay? If I had a $10,000 Toyota Corolla here and an $8,000 here one, you know what we're looking at? Budget vehicles. If we were shopping budget vehicles right now, okay, that's fair. Doesn't really matter. But when we're talking luxury cars, cars with 2,000-3,000 miles, when you're talking about Mercedes store to Mercedes store, here's what I'll tell you. If that would have been the right car for you, you wouldn't even be here with me right now. It would be sitting out in the driveway, and guess what? You wouldn't be wasting any more of your time, because how much time have you spent with me today? 2 hours?
2 hours.
So guess what? That's another 1,000. How much time have you spent on the internet looking around for cars? Another 2 hours? There's another 1,000. Look, sir, you've already spent $3,500 in time shopping to find the right vehicle. Had you found this car first, that would have already been the best deal. But you didn't. I want to share this with you, okay? Something that I take a lot of pride in, I want you to listen to this, is making you happy. You see this right here? I don't care what your payment is. I don't care how much you spend. But at the end of the day, if you don't love your vehicle, you're going to keep this car for at least 3 or 4 years. Would you agree?
I agree.
For those 3 or 4 years, there's 365 days in a year. Take that times 4. Guess what? That's 1,500 days. For the next 1,500 days, you're going to be happy in this car. Or you could settle and save yourself another $2,000. I'm going to tell you, I can't, and I don't see yourself justifying a $2,000 difference for spending 1,500 days in the wrong car. With that being said, Mr. and Mrs. Customer, here's what I'll explain to you. It's your money. You work hard for it. You put your money in the bank. When the money's spent, guess what? You've already wasted this $3,500 in time trying to find the right vehicle. If you're looking to put price in your driveway, price will never make you happy. You can go back and buy this $37,000 car, and when you put it in your driveway, whatever it is that made it not where you wanted to buy it while you were there, guess what? That same feeling, you're going to live with for 1,500 days. No. Sir, at $39,900, you're making the best decision. You're buying a vehicle that you love. And you know that in the end, guess what? For the next 4 years that you own this car, you made the right choice. You're a very smart man. If you'll sign here, I'll get your new car cleaned up. Thank you so much.
A couple of things that stood out to me. You compliment them about the money. So you make them treat them like they have a lot of money.
Grant Cardone says one thing. If you treat people like they're broke, they'll spend like they're broke.
Yeah.
If you treat people like they're a millionaire, they'll spend like they're a millionaire. If you treat them like a billionaire, they'll spend like they're a billionaire. Guess what? Notice how I keep talking about how much money you make and how you do great?
Yeah, money's nothing to you.
You can always make more money, but you can't get back time.
Yeah.
Hell, you've already spent that money searching for the right car. You spent $3,500 trying to find this car.
Amazing. That's really good.
See what I'm saying?
That's super good.
Bro, listen, this guy's not escaping me. You think he's going to walk away from this? No. I'm hitting him at the weak points of what Mercedes buyers stand to.
Yeah.
And you notice how I used a Toyota Corolla? And I said, this is Toyota Corolla. I get it, right? But it's not.
Yeah. Is it like you're taking it away and then giving it back or no? Or that's different?
Yeah. I didn't really take it away the whole time. I just made him want it more. And I made him realize that in his heart, that logically he can make a decision over money. But at the end of the day, is he going to really own something for 1,500 days that was just based off of price, not off the way he loved the vehicle? Are you kidding me? Can I ask you a question, sir? You're married, right?
Yeah.
You got a wife? I'm going to tell you this. When your wife picked your home, okay, because I know you didn't pick it. She probably picked it. As much as you loved things about it, most important thing to your house that your wife picked out was probably the kitchen, because that's where she spends the most time. And I'm going to tell you something. Could you imagine you buying a house that was $10,000 less for your wife that didn't have the perfect kitchen, and she had to live in it for the next 5 years? Every night she cooked the dinner, family dinner, okay? All the time she spent in that kitchen, the kitchen is the center of the house, all that time that she spent, guess what? You think that would start eating at her eventually? You think she'd be like, we should have spent the other 10 grand and let me at least get the kitchen I loved. Is it really worth spending the money, right, on something that we love so that we have the best life now? How many lives do you get? Last time I checked, we're not a cat. We don't get 9 lives. We get 1. We live at our best. Am I right?
Right.
Try buying your wife the house with the wrong kitchen. Look, I'm going to tell you this. You know the number one biggest decision Consumer Reports said this last year that a person can make? purchasing a home. You know what? It just got replaced with purchasing a car. We spend more time in our car than we do in our homes. And even if you have a home, if you don't have a car, you can't get to work. If you can't get to work, you can't keep your home. The car has become the number one asset of the world for a family. I'm gonna say this. You're gonna spend more time in this car than doing anything else. At the end of the day, don't settle on the number one thing. Don't buy your wife a house with the wrong kitchen. You've chose the right kitchen. Just because this house has a better deal and it's not the kitchen you love, don't look at the money. People who make decisions based off money make bad decisions, especially when they make as much money as you. Make decisions that you know that you want to live with for the next 1,500 days. Okay?
Okay.
You'll sign here. I'm going to get your car cleaned up. You're a smart man. Thank you so much. I appreciate you. And I'm just going to move.
Yeah.
Hey, did you see I pulled that wife kitchen deal?
You
ain't never heard of that one.
I
have
it.
Hey, am I right? You want to buy your wife a house with the wrong kitchen?
It's a great analogy.
Yeah.
It makes you start thinking about
just
other
because
stuff.
You spent $10,000, right, less, but you got your wife the house with the wrong kitchen. Do you know your wife's going to spend most of her time in that house, in that kitchen? And the whole time she's going to be thinking, the whole time, I really would have been happier in that other kitchen.
Mm-hmm.
But you say $10,000, I'm going to tell you this. I could see a man right now with no money in his savings account, but have the right house for his wife, versus the man that has $10,000 in his savings account and has have his wife in a house with the wrong kitchen. Who do you think's happier?
The guy
with no
right
money.
Kitchen. Yeah.
In the right kitchen. Okay? So when I say that, listen, you already know and you have your mind made up on what car you want to know. Do me a favor. Don't stress yourself out over the money.
Mm.
Okay? If you think about all the silly money that we spend here and there and here and there, could we really have what we wanted? Yeah. Guess what? You need to be focusing on those other silly things you're spending money on and start spending money on the things that are most important to you. Okay?
Awesome. That's dope.
Yeah, that's it. Look, you got one-time spins accidentally happening everywhere.
Mm.
Fix those. This is something you're going to own the whole time.
What about one price? AutoNation one price policy.
So there I go. Same thing. Used, nothing changes.
Used vehicles, we have one price and they want a discount on the car. Same thing, defend it the same way.
Have I even asked or tried to give you a discount the entire time?
No.
No, same thing. Nothing changes.
So if you give me $500, I'll buy the car right now. $500 off, I'll buy the car right
I'm
now.
I'm out of money. No, it's not the way we do things. Look, let me explain this to you. You're very important to me, number one, okay? Watch the way I psychologically play with you here. Look, I can't. I'm out of money, but I want to explain something to you. I appreciate the fact that you asked for it, okay? I want to share something with you. At the end of the day, okay, we spend expensive money, lots of money on tools that price our vehicles for us. We don't even price our own cars. We're 85% to market on this car already, okay? We're 85% to market. I want to ask you something, okay? At the end of the day, right, we've learned something. We only compare with reputable companies like ours that have the stars and the ratings that we have, and we price to market those cars based on the color of interior. Because I'm going to tell you this, there's one out there right now that's got a tan interior like this that's $2,000 less. We don't care about that car. The statistics show that 99.9% of the consumers on the market want this car. The car with the tan interior, the car that doesn't have the passenger power 8-way adjustable seat, the car that has the navigation, the sunroof, the leather, and the same wheels, but it doesn't have the sunroof, that's not the same car. They don't want that car. They want this car, okay? These cars were built magically, okay, for a certain buyer. When they created this package, this was the most unique, hottest package out there. You hear me?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so when I say this, at the end of the day, whenever you ask for a better deal, I respect that and I appreciate that, okay? But what I'll tell you is, we've already done the research for you, so you don't have to worry about it. And I will tell you this, all right? Our inventory is very selective. We don't go to the auction and just raise our hands, buy as many as we can, and put them out here for sale and hope people come to buy them. We don't rely on hope and chances. We only select unique pieces, like this one, for unique customers, just like you, who don't want to settle for a better price, but want the best and are willing to be happy in the end, okay? Again, sir, if you'll sign here, I'll get your new car cleaned up for you. Thank you so much. I appreciate you very much. You're awesome. Again, I don't want to sell you the car you buy today. I want to sell you every car you buy for the rest of your life. Mm. Thank you, thank you, and thank you. Sign here. I'm going to get your car cleaned up. That's it. I don't change. Am I making any of this friction?
No.
Am I doing this with you?
No.
And when price comes out, what do people start doing? Where did you get that from?
Yeah.
Where did you see that?
Yeah.
Hey, I'm telling you, listen, we're not going to be the cheapest in price. And I'm okay with that. I'm okay with that. I don't want to be the cheapest in price. Can I ask you a question? If you go to do business with a great company, right? And they're high in all the critical areas that are important in your family, and they give you everything that you want, and it's exactly what you want, and they're high in all the business areas, shouldn't they be a little higher in price? Or do you think that they should be the cheapest? Great business doesn't work that way, does it?
Does not.
So you can understand, as long as the justification's there why you should spend more, it's worth it. I buy a Yeti. It says you can keep ice in it, right?
Yeah.
Okay? A Yeti. It says you can keep ice in it for 7 days and it won't melt. I look over here and I've got another. It says Yetsies. Okay? And in 24 hours, the ice is melted, but that one's half the price. Dude, don't do that. Price means nothing. And I'm not telling you that your money's not important. That's not what I mean when I say price means nothing. I'm saying that your average trade cycle of our consumer that buys cars like this is 4 years. Wouldn't you love to own this car 4 years? 4 years is 1,500 days. For 1,500 days, think about it. For an extra $500 to have the car that you love and that you want to have, I'd give another $2,000 for that, right? But I'm not asking you for $2,000. Okay, that $39.99, sign here, we'll get your new car cleaned up. Mm-hmm. And you notice how I just hand you that pen, I stuck it right in your hand,
yeah.
And I keep patting you right here. I'm pushing you, I'm scooping you, I'm momentuming you, I'm getting you to move, okay?
So you just put it straight in the hand?
Yeah, watch this.
And then that.
Watch this, so check this out. So at the $39.99, here, notice I keep putting my hand out?
Yeah.
Watch, it's a gentleman's agreement, okay? With your wife could be here. So at $39.99, guys, look, you would spend an extra $2,000 if you knew what it would like. If I could fast forward and show you what your life would look like in the other car that you didn't buy this one in, that you lived in for 1,500 days, and you could come back to the table right now and spend another $500 and buy this car and be happy for 1,500 days, you guys would owe me a steak dinner every day for the rest of your life. I promise you. We think of things logically and with our gut. And our gut tells us which one we'll be happy with in the end, and logically we think here about money. But at the end of the day, you can always get more money, but you can never get more time. At least we know the next 1,500 days that you're owning this car, you're spending your money on something you're spending all of your time in. Does that make sense? Awesome. Thank you so much for your business, sir. Thank you so much for your business, ma'am. Sir, if you'll just sign that right there, you're gonna sign right there, I'll get your new car cleaned up. Thank you so much.
Yeah, I got you.
Every time, push, I push. And here's the deal. Do I have pressure right now? Hell yeah, I do. But is it low pressure or high pressure?
It's low pressure.
Low. Can you even feel it, really?
No.
You know why?
It's very sneaky.
Sell like a lion, act like a lamb. Do I look like a lamb?
No.
Well, but I'm like a lamb.
But you're acting like one, yeah.
Yeah, I'm like a lamb. Bro, I'm a lion inside. I know exactly what I'm doing.
Yeah, so
okay? But do you think people want to deal with an ass kisser or a freaking person that can help them make a decision?
Somebody that can help them make a decision.
That's Am I making all your decisions for you?
Yes.
But you feel like you're the one who's making it, right?
Yeah.
I hold the spotlight and you're in it. Who has a spotlight?
Yeah.
Who's in it?
Okay, so
that is a professional negotiation.
What I'm looking to do.
Makes sense,
yeah.
Doesn't it?
Yeah, it makes a lot of sense.
Call it ninja shit, baby. Hey, I'm going to turn this off right now
because
this is our prize. I don't know what you think about this for a minute.
Amazing. That's really good.
You know, I told you, bro. Nobody teaches it like this in the world.